one person in Washington who gets it. Senator Tom Coburn from Oklahoma. Our government needs to refinance now, lock in these ultra low rates. So the strongest demand we had in 30 years, incredibly strong demand. We have got to do this, and we got to get rid of the financial chaos that's causing everyone in the world that is, well, frankly, they're sending our money here because of the chaos. It's the safe haven, selling $2 trillion in 30-year treasuries. Well, let me just say it's what any responsible homeowner would try to do, like locking in on a 30-year fixed mortgage. Administration don't want to do it. Tim Geithner's against it. Doesn't seem interested in the solution. And we love Geithner. They think short-term it'll cost too much money. They're not thinking long-term. This is a hugely important issue, people. It's not on the radar. We need to rally behind Senator Coburn, who understands the importance of getting a handle on the national debt in order to get our nation's financial house in order. Coburn's got what I call horse sense. He's a proponent of also embracing natural gas in order to ensure America's energy independence, our favorite crusade here on Mad Money. That's why I'm thrilled to have him on the show tonight. Senator Coburn, welcome to Mad Money.
Hey, Jim, great to be with you.
Thank you, sir. Senator, what would you please explain why our government isn't as smart as the people themselves who know they should be locking in these long-term rates, and we see it happening with massive refinances all the time?
Well, it's a short term. They're doing a short term calculation, Jim. If we move from 2 year or 1 year or 90 day to 30 year, what happens to the interest rate? It goes up. The problem is when we're smart enough to buy to extend our credit out to 30 years, it's not going to be at 3% or 4%. It's going to be at 6 or 7%. So what they're wasting, they're afraid to spend a dollar today to prevent us from spending $10 or $12 in the future. And the liquidity crisis is going to come on with us within the next 18 months to 2 years. There's no question about that. And we're not going to anticipate it. When we start doing it when the value of the dollar is sinking rather than rising, the cost is going to go ever higher. And it should be more than $2 trillion, Jim. What we should also do is bail out Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and put another $1.6 trillion in that. And then you've got a long-term basis that's far below. And then if we need to manipulate to help people out of mortgages, you know what we could do? We could cut 200 basis points off their mortgages.
You're absolutely right. I have to admit, I thought my plan was bold with $2 trillion. You're absolutely right. There is demand out there, isn't there, for $3.5, $4 trillion. We saw that today, didn't we?
Well, there is, and it's going to continue until things settle down in Europe and until Japan solves its problems. Japan isn't going to solve its problems easily. But over the next 2 years, we have a window. And the other reason is they don't want to recognize the interest cost that would come along with that because they don't really want to make the tough cuts in the budget to keep it budget neutral. You know, it'll cost us $100 billion or $70 billion more to do this.
But anybody who's a homeowner knows sometimes you got to pay those points up front in order to be able to lock in a rate that saves you tens of thousands of dollars over the lifetime of a house. Why? Senator, Tim Geithner's not a dumb man. He must know this stuff.
No, they're walking a tightrope. They think they're smart enough to anticipate the markets. We've proven none of us are smart enough to anticipate the markets, not even the famous Jim Cramer.
Well,
you can't do it all the time. And we're playing with the future of our country. Let's talk about what happens if we don't.
Okay.
Let's see what happens if over the next 2 years, 30-year rates rise 200 basis points. What's that going to cost? And if they rise 200 basis points, what's going to happen to short-term rates? They're going to go up as well, aren't they?
Right.
Now, maybe not in the next year, but in the next 18 months to 2 years, we're going to start seeing rates drift higher. And when that happens, the cost for us to refinance our debt and extend the window, because the only way we don't become Greece is to buy time to get out of the liquidity crisis that we're going to face. Otherwise, what you're going to do is see a big differential in our bonds and everybody else, especially China, especially other sovereign funds that are mineral-based or natural resource-based. You're going to see this widespread,
Senator,
and we're going to pay the price.
They're going to come after us, aren't they, these bond vigilantes, after they're done wrecking Europe? Aren't they going to come after the United States?
Well, I think they are, but I think we have a year to 18 months before they do that, because we're seeing this flight to the dollar right now like crazy.
Right.
It's moderated a little bit in the last week, but it's going to continue because they're not through working through the problems in Europe.
One point I want to give you in the last minute. You are, I know some people when I brought this up said, well, you're just encouraging more profligate spending. Senator Coburn, you've been the leader of cutting spending, right? I mean, I don't want to make it sound like that you're trying to buy time to do more spending.
Well, this isn't about more spending. Look, Congress is addicted to spending. We need a 12-step program like alcoholics or any other addicted one. I've got one. I'm going to be introducing that. The fact is we're borrowing $3.8 billion
a day
that we don't have to spend on things we don't need.
Senator Coburn.
And our children are going to pay that back, and our grandchildren.
That's exactly right. Senator Coburn, you are a delight. Thank you for taking this cause up for all the people who watch this show and for all of America. Great to have you on the show, sir.
Good to be with you.
Thank you. Senator Coburn does indeed have horse sense. Boy, do we ever have to follow this.